Novely audiobook present. The Rebirth of the Malicious Empress of Military Lineage, Chapter 11, Z Family's Ending. Xin Miao lowered her head and made a bashful look. Zai Jingxing died at the age of 22. The late emperor wanted to punish the Z family, and the imperial family of Ming Qi became more muddle-headed and incompetent as time passes. They did not think about how to develop the country's strength, but instead thought all the time about how to protect themselves. The vassal families were all threats, as per Fu Ziyuyi. Shen family objective was to live honestly, and since the Zi family did not listen to the imperial commands, naturally they were the thorn in the late emperor's eyes. When the Xiongnu attacked, the Zi family set off with troops with Zi Ding going into battle, but in the battlefield, the presumptuous general Zi's troops were annihilated to the last man. When Zi Jingxing waited for his father return in the middle of the year, what he waited for was the return of a coffin. Zi Ding's death was not the end. During the funeral, the people in the Ding capital sent Zi Ding off, and the entire country was in mourning. To the imperial family, this was a big taboo. Thus it did not took long for the appointment of the young Zi Jingxing to lead the military campaign on behalf of his father. It was not Zi Jingxing's first battle. Like the Zi family, his talent on the battlefield was enough to make the enemy terrified. But despite obviously knowing the queer nature of Zi Ding's death, this imperial edict still pushed Zi Jingxing to the road of death. Zi Jingxing still received the imperial edict, went into the battlefield, and was defeated. That day he was exposed to the enemy and became the target, and thus ended up with thousands of arrows through his heart. Not only that, for unknown reasons the body was taken away, and the Xiongnu skin it and hang the body up in the tower to dry to serve a warning to others. The tragic outcome was played again, and Ming Qi went into a national mourning. Father and son made the battlefield their funeral, and the commoners could only see that the Xiongnu were brutal and the heroic acts of the generals, but they did not see that the undercurrent of this conspiracy. At that time the late emperor was already approach his coffin, thus Fu Ziyuyi took over the affairs of the court. In order to express regret in the bitter outcome of the Zi family, he conferred titles to the father and son of the Zi family. Since the titles were useless for the father and son of the Zi family, it appeased the court, and the concubine and the two Shu sons had all the advantages. Xin Miao still remember Xin Xin's look of pain when he came to know of Zi Jingxing's death. She initially thought that the Zi and Shen family were like water and fire, and thus when the Zi family fall into despair, her father would not be sad about it. Now to think about it, it was most likely at that time when Shen Xin felt the feeling of the fox grieving when the rabbit dies. Since the balance was broken with the collapse of the Zi family, the next one would be the Shen family. The ridiculous thing was, at that time she single-mindedly pushed the Shen family into this muddy water of the fight of the throne. Shen Miao did not have any feelings for the Zi family, and in the beginning she only felt some regret towards the fate of this young man. Such an outstanding young man should be leaving a legacy in the country of Ming Qi, and who would have expected such an ending? He knew that the imperial edict was a seal of death, but he still went. Perhaps it was in order to preserve the dignity of the Zi family and to prove that to the very end that the Zi family loyalty to the country. But knowing that it cannot be avoided, and yet he still proceeded, showed that this unruly Zi Jingxing was not ordinary. He was an extremely upright and brave person. As Shen Miao was thinking about it, Kai Lin squeezed out from the crowd and handed to Zi Jingxing a small clothed bag, saying respectfully, "Little Marquis, this is the medical book that you told me to find." For a little overlord to be this respectful to others, it shocked the teeth out of everyone. But after some thought, it would be as such as Zi Jing was the capital's overlord. The Zi family was the overlord of the overlords, and which such a mind one would be able to understand Kai Lin's attitude to Zi Jingxing. Feng Anning quietly whispered into Shen Miao's ears, "What do you think of little Zi Marquis compared to His Highness Prince Ding?" Shen Miao choked a little. She was not used to how well Feng Anning suddenly treated her. She seriously said, "Little Zi Marquis is better." Not only better, in her view, Fu Ziyuyi, such a black-hearted villain, cannot be compared with Zi Jingxin. In the beginning, when Wan Yu and Fu Ming studied the history of Ming Qi and read the part of the Zi family, They would secretly tell her that they felt that Xi Jingxing was a good man through and through, and his death was a such a pity. Even her own son and daughter praised this youth. Naturally, he must be good. Feng Anning was somewhat surprised and took a long while before she said, "It really seems that you are truly hurt." Xin Miao cannot be bothered to explain to her. They saw Xi Jingxin, who was on horseback, casually held the saddle and gave Kai Lin a look. Without any additional words, he pulled the horse leash and turned away chicly. The horse stirred up a cloud of soot, but it could not conceal the charm of the youth on horseback. Like the sun in the skies, he was covered in a bright light in one's eyes. Kai Lin was somewhat at a loss, and the surrounding females did not conceal their disappointment as they thought that Xi Jingxing would stay for a longer time. The strange thing was that Xi Jingxing was the only one that young nobleman would not be jealous of due to his reputation with the young ladies. It could be that his way of doing things and personality was different from other, which made others respect. Behind her eyes, Shen Miao was doing some reflection. After overthrowing the Xi family, the Shen family would be ushering in monstrous disaster. Since the two are closely related, why not ease the situation? If the imperial family want to get involved, then they would have to consider if they have the ability. Saving the Xi family, saving Xi Jingxing, only with that it would give the Shen family an additional bargaining chip. Shen family is honest and sincere, while Xi family is bossy and domineering. The imperial family would first deal with the Xi family, and she, perhaps, may be able to make a deal with the Xi family. Xi Jingxing rode all the way and finally stopped his horse in front of a tavern. He flipped down the horse and walked to the innermost of the tavern. In the room there was a white-clad handsome youth that smiled upon seeing him. "Third younger brother, take it." Xi Jingxing threw the bag in his hands over. "In the future, don't find for me for such things." If it was not Gao Ying who request him to find this whatever medical book, he would not go to Kai Lin and would not be surrounded in Guangwen Tang like a fool. Thinking of that silk blossom, he felt disgusted as he patted his clothes. Gao Yang knew that this junior of his was a little odd and smiled lightly to joke, "You should go around more with this temper of yours. These students' age are similar to yours, and you should learn to be as lively as them." He paused and with a slight urging smile, "Perhaps there would be an adorable young lady. You are at the right age. Why are you still alone all day?" Xi Jingxing was already accustomed to the straightforward and quiet nature of his senior and wrote it off in a slightly impatient manner as he thought of the pair of eyes that he saw. They were a pair of clear eyes like an animal, with a deep sense of compassion and helplessness. That kind of look not only made him stun, but afterwards the owner looked down in a seemingly shy manner. But what kind of person was Xi Jingxing? He followed his father and traveled extensively, fought battles and killed people, so he has a trained pair of eyes. That girl was only pretending to admire him, but it was unfortunate that she did not know that her pair of eyes were like a pool of stagnant water, without a single trace of wave. It was truly interesting.